Uneasy lies the head that wears the crown. It is common knowledge. We all know that presidents age more rapidly when they are in office than regular people do. I was just reading that Barack Obama has aged 2 years for everyone. But you, Professor Olshansky, have been studying longevity, human longevity, for some time. So tell me, have I been reading the right stuff on the internet?
It's not true.
Look, what?
The funny thing is, because that's actually what prompted me to study this to begin with, was I was watching TV when Barack Obama came into Chicago for his 50th birthday, and there were some people on TV saying, you know, he looks a whole lot older, and my understanding is that you age at twice the normal rate while you're in office. And I said, well, I don't know that to be true, and I work in the field of aging. But this is an eminently testable hypothesis. You know, I actually went and did the analysis within a very short time period. You know, we haven't had that many presidents. And I looked at all of the data.
When you did decide to study this as an academic, what metrics do you look at when assessing the aging of presidents?
Under the assumption that they're aging at twice the rate while they're in office, I assume that for every 1 year in office, they're living 2 years of biological time. So if you're in office for 8 years, I assume you've lived for biologically 16 years, right? And that's exactly the assumption I made for every single president. And so then it becomes a simple analysis. I go back and I look at how long they actually lived and how long they were predicted to have lived prior to entering office, and I compared the two. And if presidents lived longer than what was predicted for people their age, then they exceeded what was predicted, and they were not experiencing accelerated aging. And if they died sooner, which is what your hypothesis would be, was that they would die before other people because they're living at twice the rate while they're in office, then they should be dying sooner. And that's not what I saw. Let me be clear. It's possible that presidents go through accelerated graying and accelerated skin aging while they're in office due to stress. That's a distinct possibility. But the outward, just because you're going through accelerated graying and accelerated wrinkling of the skin on the outside, it doesn't mean that inside they're aging more rapidly. And I would guess, by the way, that stress to presidents is a form of energy. So the presidents have done exceedingly well. And one of the reasons why they've done exceedingly well is something that we know about in public health and we've known about for a long time, and that's access. Maybe access is the only word you need to hear. It's access to money, access to wealth, access to health care, access to education. It's basic inequities that exist in the population. And when you supply those benefits to any subgroup of the population, they're going to do much better. And that's the case with presidents. Presidents have done much better. It's not true that they age at double the rate. It's not true that they die sooner. On average, they live significantly longer than the rest of us.
Thank you very much, Professor S.J. Olshansky. And I hope you have a great aging process.
Wonderful. And we live as healthy and as long as possible in that order.